The Truth's Most Powerful Ally by A.W. Tozer. The most effective argument for Christianity is still the good lives of those who profess it. A company of pure living and cheerful Christians in the community is a stronger proof that Christ is risen than any learned treatise ever could be. And the further advantage is that while the average person could not be hired to read a theological work, no one can ever evade the practical argument presented by the presence of holy men and women. To the sons and daughters of this tense and highly mechanized age, a holy life may seem unpardonably dull and altogether lacking in interest. But among all the fancy, interest-catching toys of the world, a holy life stands apart as the only thing slated to endure. The stars make no noise, says the Italian proverb, yet they have outlived all man's civilizations, and in their unassuming silence have shone on through the centuries, preaching their simple doctrine of God and enduring things. Francis of Assisi composed some sublime hymns and preached some quaint sermons, but for none of these is he known, and by none of these has he captured the moral imagination of mankind. The utter purity of his life is which has won him a lasting place in the hearts of every seeker after God. When the church in America rejected the example of good men and chose for her pattern the celebrity of the hour, she suffered a greater loss than she has since discovered. Human greatness cannot be determined by popularity polls, nor by the number of lines any man writes in the public press. It is altogether unlikely that we know who our greatest men are. One thing is sure, however, the greatest man alive today is the best man alive today. That is not open to debate. To discover the good, great man, granted that it would be in our profit to do so, would require more than human wisdom. For the holy man is also the humble man, and the humble man will not advertise himself, nor allow others to do it for him. Spiritual virtues run deep and silent, like the tide or the pull of gravitation or the shining of the sun. They work without noise, but their gracious ministrations are felt around the whole earth. The Christian who is zealous to promote the cause of Christ can begin by living in the power of the Spirit, and so reproducing the life of Christ in the sight of men. In deep humility and without ostentation, he can let his light shine. The world may pretend not to see, but it will see. Nevertheless, and more than likely, it will get into serious trouble with its conscience over what it sees.